New with this release, you'll find a Show Analysis Tools menu located at the bottom right corner of your screen. This menu contains familiar tools such as a curve surface analysis and interference detection, but also has a new tool, Dihedral Analysis. Dihedral Analysis allows you to view the angle of deviation between two faces, evaluated at an edge. On the right side of this simple model, the faces are nearly identical and therefore show a very low angle of dihedral. However, moving to the left, the faces connect at sharper and sharper angles as the curves diverge, and therefore show increasing values of dihedral. The minimum and maximum value across the selection is automatically displayed both in the dialog as well as its location on screen. Threshold values may also be applied to color the combs appropriately, and the scale may be adjusted. Dihedral is an important analysis tool for advanced surfacing design, as it helps you quickly understand how smoothly two faces are meeting. In this example of a drone frame, we can quickly verify that the top and bottom faces of the housing have nearly zero dihedral, even at critical points of importance, such as around the motor mounts. You'll now find a new feature to create isoclines. An isocline is a curve on a surface based on an angle of deviation from a selected reference. In this simple example, notice as we increase our angle, the generated curve moves further away from the reference plane, just as we can observe that the surface itself has angled further away from the front plane. You may flip the direction of creation of the isocline using the arrow. You can choose to create a curve or to directly split the face within the isocline feature. An isocline is a very precise way to generate a curve on a complex surface. In this example, we can create an isocline at a specific angle of deviation on this drone body. We'll use this curve to then split and cleanly cut back an area of the surface. We can then use surfacing techniques and other features to build a new, softer blend to rejoin to the housing below. Onshape now includes the ability to create custom profile libraries for frames. This will greatly benefit those organizations that utilize proprietary or non-standard extrusion profiles. To get started, create a folder at your Documents page and name it something identifiable as your library. You'll then create a nested folder within this to define the name standard. You can have multiple folders at this level, each for different standards you want to manage. Next, you'll create a document for your profiles. We've pre-created one here in the interest of saving time. The document will have one profile per part studio stored as a single closed sketch. If you need different sizes of a profile, you may configure the profile sketch to have multiple sizes. It is best practice to tag your profiles using the Tag Profiles feature. Here, you can add additional attachment points or cutlass properties as well. In this example, we'll quickly just fill in the standard and description. Once this is complete, version your document. Finally, you'll move the document into the nested folder structure you created in the previous step, before closing it. Back at the Documents page, right-click on the Library folder and select the option Set Library, My Frame Profiles. A message will appear at the top of the screen, and the icon on the folder will change to indicate it has been updated to your frame's element library. You may now use it. When creating a frame, click the Profile Sketch, select your library, type, profile, and optionally configure the size. For further information on setup and management of your element library, please refer to the help documentation. Previously, you've had the ability to add inspection items to Onshape drawings, and even export an inspection list. However, new with this release, you'll find the inspection table is directly visible from the right side panel within your drawing. The inspection table shows all assigned and unassigned dimensions in the drawing. It includes columns for sheet, type, units, and the various values. First, you can filter the view between showing dimensions across all sheets or just the current sheet you are viewing. As dimensions are assigned an inspection number, notice they are automatically ordered sequentially in the table. Previously created items can also be reordered from the drawing sheet or directly from the table itself. Any inspection items associated in a previous release will remain locked. Finally, the inspection table can be exported to a CSV. The resultant export will only include assigned item numbers, even if there are unassigned dimensions in your drawing and table view. A few releases back, an option was introduced allowing you to change the auxiliary view reference format to an arrow style. With this release, you may now dimension directly off of that arrow onto an edge of the parent model. This allows you to quickly call out the angle of that auxiliary view. When creating a projected view off of a section view, the default behavior will ignore the cut. However, you may include the cut in your projected view by simply holding the Shift key prior to placing the view. At any point from the view properties, you can select to apply or ignore the parent section cut.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.